Es ist auf jeden Fall ein Thema Richtung KI, Cyborg-mäßig irgendwas. Schauen wir mal. Kommt was? Also erstmal irgendein mir unbekannter Entwickler, irgendein unbekannter Distributor. If a machine is expected to be infallible, it cannot also be intelligent. Alan Turing. Beides war okay. Irgendeine Zukunftsmetropole. Ich kann das nicht lesen. Zorro? Sagen wir Zorro, ja. Zwei Personen auf dem Dach. Okay. Lootende Maschine. Oder ein Mensch mit einem synthetischen Arm. Vielleicht so Cyberpunk-mäßig. Welta Laboratories Local Netlink Synergia Protocol Server 01. Initiating Startup Sequence. Test Models on. Initiating Mara. Bin ich im Weg? Ah, nee. Gerade so am Rand. Bin zu langsam. Silla? Mara? Okay. Yoko? Kyle da. Okay, es klingt nach so einem Special Squad. Mir läuft so ein kleiner Schauer über den Rücken, weil es erinnert mich halt so an Ghost in the Shell gerade. Und das ist meine Lieblings-Anime-Serie. Anime-Serie. Mist, wieder versprochen. Dementsprechend habe ich aber auch gewisse Grundanforderungen, weil wenn die jetzt einfach nur platt Ghost in the Shell kopieren, dann ist das Spiel bei mir leider unten durch. Ich hoffe, die haben dann einen eigenen Spin. Ja, ich habe halt vor 20 Jahren immer Anime gesagt. Und ich versuche mich an Anime zu gewöhnen. Oh. Das ist genau Enemy. Ja. Bohrt nur nach. Ah, wenigstens merke ich es jetzt schon selber. Wenn man halt was falsch lernt, ist es halt umso schwerer, davon abzukommen. Beziehungsweise was vielleicht früher richtig war in dem Kontext. Zum Beispiel heißt es Al-Qaida oder El-Qaida oder Al-Qaida. Das war auch so ein Ding, was mich so total genervt hat. Vor 20 Jahren hieß es halt Al-Qaida und irgendwann hört man Al-Qaida in den Nachrichten. Okay, das ist so ein Ding, ja, Terroristen, was soll's, lassen wir mal weg. Ein anderes Beispiel war Hera. Ich bin es so gewohnt, ich bin mit Herkules aufgewachsen und Xena. Und da gab es halt Hera und irgendeine Serie hat dann plötzlich Hera gesagt. Also, da dachte ich mir auch, warum wurde das eingeenglischt? Andererseits, vielleicht ist es ja einfach nur wirklich, dass es jemand aus dem Englischen dann übernommen hat, weil es da halt mehr so ausgesprochen wird. Und dass halt die ursprüngliche deutsche Version demjenigen nicht bekannt war. Dass mal manche, gerade wenn es Eigennamen sind, sie anders ausspricht. Ist es China oder China? Ich sag China. Genau. Dann gibt es noch immer wieder so örtliche kleine Betonungskriege. Chemnitz oder Chemnitz? Al-Qaida. Gott. Alkohol und AIDA ist für mich ein gekentertes nicht Frachtschiff. Personenschiff gewesen, oder? War die AIDA nicht mal vor 15 Jahren oder so wochenlang in den Nachrichten? Ah, Gott, oh Gott. Alk gibt es auf der AIDA. Oder ist es sogar wieder ein fahrendes Schiff? Also für mich ist, wenn ein Schiff mal gekentert ist und liegen blieb, ist das gestorben. So ähnlich wie Titanic gibt es hoffentlich auch nicht nochmal eine. Urlaub und Trips, okay. So, Synergia. Im Endeffekt, ich erwarte ein bisschen Cyberpunk mit einem eigenen Spin, mit einer interessanten Geschichte. Ja, schauen wir einfach rein. Click anywhere. Oh, ich muss mit der Maus. QB, Nabend, was ist denn? Ein Spiel, was du auch mal sehen wolltest? Oder die Haare? Wahrscheinlich die Haare jetzt noch nach der Reaktion. Ich darauf einen Schluck. Das Rot ist aber richtig farbresistent. Das wehrt sich gegen den Regenbogen. Aber der Flusen, der tanzt in allen Farben in der Ecke. So. Dankeschön. Du erinnerst dich an den Namen auch. Okay. Prinzipiell, Follower-Emotes sind jetzt aktiv. Jeder kann fürs Flusen geben, auch wenn es jetzt nicht unbedingt die schönsten sind. Die schönsten sind noch immer im Sub und im Bit. Also die 1000 Bits Herzflusen, oder der 1000 Bit Herzflusen, den habe ich. Oh, das Spiel sieht so eigentlich viel mächtiger aus. Der Herzflusen, also ihr könnt im Discord gerne euren Senf dazu schreiben, wie ihr meint, dass vielleicht die Flusen besser angeordnet werden, dann schiebe ich die mal rum. Und ich dachte mir halt, bevor ich den Herzflusen, den man ja überall in jedem Channel nehmen soll, auf Sub gebe ich den lieber nur auf die niedrigste Bitstufe, die mir möglich ist, damit man die einmal investiert und dann hat man den auf ewig, solange Twitch existiert. Oder solange dieser Kanal existiert. So, das ist der Hintergrund dahinter, nicht um Bits zu baiten. Aber ich habe halt jetzt halt, alle Sachen, die ich auch noch geplant hatte für Sub, habe ich halt jetzt halt einfach reingehauen in die Follower, weil hat ja keinen Sinn, dass die noch länger rumliegen. Okay, soviel zur Eigenwerbung. machen wir noch weiter mit der Eigenwerbung. Weil ich gesehen habe, ihr habt noch nicht so viele Punkte in das Adventure, in der Community Challenge rein. Es gibt das Adventure The Longest Journey. Und The Longest Journey ist, glaube ich, eine alte Klassikerperle. Ich weiß nicht, wie lang es ist und wie schwer es ist. Und Adventures sind generell ein bisschen schwer zuzugucken, glaube ich. Aber ich will nur noch mal die Aufmerksamkeit kurz darauf lenken, dass ihr da noch was reinmacht. Machst du ein GG-Emote? Puh, ich wüsste halt nicht, wie ich da den Flusen einbinden kann. Ich mag halt keine Sprach-Emotes. Also ich mag nicht so Buchstaben einfach reinhauen. Ich bräuchte halt irgendwie was halt GG durch ein Gesicht mit Haaren und Füßen sichtbar macht. Ich bin dafür Vorschläge offen. Gut, Füße haben im Prinzip so ein bisschen eine G-Form. Also wenn du dir die Füße von dem Hai-Flusen anguckst oder von dem Hype, der da von dir vorher gemacht wurde, da kannst du den unteren Fuß so ein bisschen als G interpretieren. Ich könnte zwei Füße vielleicht machen, die man als GG interpretieren könnte, aber dann versteht das wieder nicht jeder. Irgendeiner, der sich freut oder dachte der erst an The Journey Down. Nee, The Longest Journey ist ein Spiel in der Zukunft, wo im Prinzip Personen mit einem Einschlafgerät in die Traumwelt wechseln können und im Prinzip luzide Träume haben können. Vielleicht erzähle ich jetzt auch nur Schmarrn, aber diese Traumwelt, in die sie wechseln, also Lucid Dreaming, ist im Prinzip, man ist sich bewusst, dass es da ein Traum ist und man kann den Traum formen und leiten. Ich hoffe, das ist grob richtig. Und die Sache ist aber, diese Traumwelt sind in Wirklichkeit eine andere Realität, die parallel zu dieser Zukunftsgesellschaft existiert. Und diese eigene Realität hat ihre eigenen Probleme, eigenen Kriege und so. Und ist im Prinzip so eine Art Fantasy-Welt, die neben einer Zukunftswelt existiert. Und man wechselt dazu mit einem Charakter hin und her. Und es wird auf mehreren Ebenen erzählt. Ich kenne den dritten Teil, deshalb bin ich da ein bisschen gespoilert. Aber ich habe den ersten mal angefangen, nach einer halben Stunde im ersten Screen habe ich es dann wieder ausgemacht und habe dann andere Spiele wieder gespielt. Aber ich glaube, das könnte schon interessant sein. Inception? Nee. Inception war ja unterbewusst Traum, in einem Traum, in einem Traum, in einem Traum. Also, die haben ja den Traum noch nicht mal geformt. Die haben ja, obwohl, naja doch, die haben ein bisschen Einfluss auf die Person genommen und dann hat sich der Traum anders entwickelt und hat am Schluss irgendeine fixe Idee in den Kopf der Leute gepflanzt. Also im Prinzip Erinnerungsmanipulation. Aber ja. Also ich hätte es aber nicht mit Inception verglichen. Also dieses Parallelwelt und luzides Träumen. Lucid Dream. Ist das lucid oder ich spreche das wahrscheinlich total falsch aus? Dreamfall ist der Teil danach. The Longest Journey ist der erste Teil. Dreamfall ist der zweite Teil. Und Dreamfall Chapters ist der dritte Teil. Also ist das das Adventure, was Dreamfall gestartet hat. Dachte der erste ist Journey Down. Einen Pokal in die Hände drücken. Ein Pokal-Emote als GG. Ein Flusen, der aus dem Pokal rausguckt. Versuche ich mal im Hinterkopf zu behalten. Ich weiß nicht, wann ich die Zeit dafür aufwenden kann. Und jetzt sehen wir schon sehr, sehr lange diesen Startscreen. Ja? Ich sollte, glaube ich, mal klicken. Entschuldigt. Jetzt warte ich aber noch kurz ab, bis die Pixel verschwinden. Und falls ich das auf YouTube stelle, bitte ab hier starten, weil davor war viel zu viel Geschwurbel, was rund um den Kanal geht. Das kann man, also das muss man nicht unbedingt auf YouTube haben. Okay, so habe ich auch an mein Zukunfts-Ich eine Nachricht hinterlassen. Und jetzt gehen wir einfach ins Spiel Synergia. Click anywhere to continue. So, was haben wir denn? Erstmal Settings prüfen. Aber ich habe, glaube ich, schon nach Deutsch-Englisch geguckt. Es ging nur Englisch. Beziehungsweise Spanisch oder Chinesisch. Spanisch kam ich nie über ja, die erste Verwunderung, dass spanische Fragen vorne und hinten ein Fragezeichen haben. Chinesisch, nein. Englisch machen wir. So, genau, ich habe ein bisschen an der Lautstärke rum. Ich hoffe, das passt. Luzidträume sind schon wird, hatte selbst ein paar. Wenn man kapiert, dass man in einem Traum ist und dann plötzlich so diese Allmacht hat, so, aha, jetzt würde ich gerne das. Meine letzten luziden Träume liegen schon ein bisschen zurück. Und damals war es mir genug, dass ich einfach nur das High hatte, dass ich fliegen konnte, dass ich dann absichtlich getriggert habe, dass ich rumgeflogen bin. Ich weiß gar nicht, was ich mir heutzutage dann so wünschen würde. Oh, mal wieder in diese Situation kommen, überhaupt einen Traum zu behalten. Das dauert ein bisschen. Fliegen im Traum das Beste. Runterfallen, nee. Ich hatte auch genügend Sturzträume. Aber das ist echt lange her. Also, vielleicht war es damals, als ich noch so ein bisschen Kontrollverlust, dass alles für einen selber entschieden wird und mittlerweile darf man selbst ans Steuer und ist sich deshalb bewusster. Also, ich träume kaum noch. Oder zumindest behalte ich die Träume nicht. Dass sie sehr behind her eyes, übersetzt hinter ihren Augen, nennenswert. Zu luziden Träumen. Andere Empfehlung zu luziden Träumen. Paprika. Da geht es um eine Traummaschine. Und es läuft dann alles amok und irgendwie verschmelzen Realität und Traum am Schluss. Es wird ganz weird. Aber fand ich ganz nett. Und Paprika ist auch die Vorlage für einige Szenen aus Inception. Also da ist Inception einfach von dem Anime geklaut. Was aber auch ein nettes Kompliment war. Das Problem dabei ist die Kontrolle. In dem Moment, wo ich es merke, dass ich mein chaotisches Gedankengut raus, das endet nicht immer schön. Soweit hatte ich es noch nicht. Nee. Ich hatte aber auch noch eine ganz langweilige Variante, wo ich mir gesagt habe, jetzt möchte ich aufwachen. Was in Albträume umschwenken kann, wenn man aufwacht und dann plötzlich merkt, man ist aber noch im Traum. Und man plötzlich doch merkt, man hat die Kontrolle verloren. Da hatte ich auch schon mal eine Panikattacke quasi. Also zumindest bin ich da mit erhöhtem Puls dann irgendwann richtig aufgewacht. Also wenn man denkt, man hat den Traum unter Kontrolle und kann ihn doch nicht kontrollieren. Okay, Memo an mein Zukunfts-Ich. Ab jetzt, okay. Synergia, neues Spiel, irgendwas mit Cyborgs, KIs und Zukunft, denke ich mal. Es gibt mir so Ghost in the Shell Vibes. Starten wir jetzt mal das Game. Guinea-Pigs. 20 Days Before the Synergia Incident. Oh, okay, wir haben einen Countdown und da passiert was Böses. Hard Melodies are sweet, but those unhard are sweeter. Heard, hard, John Keats. Ach, Zitate. Ich warte mal kurz. Bewegt sich's von selber weiter oder muss ich klicken? Ich muss klicken. Sehr schön. Circa 44:23. Genau, ab 44:23. Bitte schneiden. Dankeschön. Gut, wir haben kein richtiges Gesicht, aber es ist wohl ein Mann von der Silhouette, würde ich sagen. Sir, our test models have left the lab. However, some issues arose. Issues? The convoy adjusted route, apparently due to a change that was made in the trailer's autopilot. After detouring from the main highway, it was then attacked not long after. Die beiden wechseln hin und her. What happened to the androids? One of them was destroyed by a fire inside the cargo unit. The rest were stolen during the attack. So we sent a deactivation signal from our main computer, but only two of them stopped transmitting their data flow. Interesting. So there are still two fully functional models. Affirmative. We have already located one of them, but the other is still missing. Is the main computer still receiving its data? Yes, sir, but the location signal is coming from the first machine. We believe it might have been able to disable the tracker. Even so, we cannot be sure without accessing the database. That would be extremely risky. Definitely not. Anyway, this could be a chance to see how these models behave in a hostile environment. Keep an eye on the functioning android and make sure it's out of danger. Find the other one. Roger said, sir. I will keep you informed. Okay, also die standen wohl zusammen, laut dem Bild im Hintergrund. Smells like ozone. 15 days before the Synergia incident. My schedule for today lists a 6-hour self-accusatory depression. Ah, okay. Das Spiel macht gerade sowas. Das finde ich ist schlechter Erzählstil. Also, so gut wie. Nee, nicht alle, aber sagen wir mal 80% der Filme, die mit einem Zitat beginnen, versuchen einfach nur eine Art Grundstimmung auf billigste Art und Weise zu etablieren. Man nimmt einfach einen coolen Spruch. Nimmt einen Namen, den die Leute kennen. Den Spruch kennen manche Leute, dann kennen sie den Namen halt nicht. Oder sie kennen den Spruch nicht und dann kennen sie den Namen. Ach, das hat der gesagt. Ah, dann muss das ja in der Richtung sein. Und das ist so ein Upturner für viele Geschichten, finde ich. Ich hoffe, die hören auf damit. Wenn die jetzt das vor jedem Kapitel machen, dann ist es vielleicht Stilmittel, aber das lässt das ganze Spiel schon so ein bisschen billig wirken. Leider, leider. Aber schauen wir mal, nicht gleich vorverurteilen alles. Junger Erzähler, Entwickler, aka noch nicht viel Erfahrung mit dem Plot rüberbringen an den Spieler. Ja, dass der halt so einen Kniff dann mitnimmt und sich so ein bisschen daran orientiert, dass, weiß jetzt nicht, haben Hunger Games das gemacht, dass so ein Zitat ist und dann kommt die Erzählung. Ich glaube mich auch grob zu erinnern, dass das Blade Runner gemacht hat, also deshalb habe ich dann auch gleich zurückgerudert und gesagt, nicht jeder Film, der mit einem Zitat beginnt, ist schlecht, aber viele Filme, finde ich, die kommen halt mit so einer Tagline und die wollen halt irgendwie eine Atmosphäre etablieren und ich finde, Leute, geht's denn noch unenthusiastischer? Und das gibt bei mir so gleich so einen kleinen Drop. Leider. Ich habe dieses Jahr sehr über Framed gelästert, als ich das gespielt habe. Es gibt es übrigens gerade diesen Monat im Amazon Prime Bundle, glaube ich, der Gratis-Spiele. Also der Spiele, wenn man halt Prime hat, die man abgreifen kann. Nicht Framed. Es war in Frames, aber es hieß anders. Egal. Ich habe da auf jeden Fall auch über die Erzählart viel gelästert, dass es nicht so gut rübergebracht ist. Es hat nur das Nötigste dann abgeliefert. Aber mal gucken, vielleicht sind die Dialoge ja noch spannend. Wobei der Dialog vorher war nüchtern, aber er war ja auch nur Informationen austauschen, von daher ist das verzeihbar. Mal gucken, was passiert. Weil das eben so Techniken sind, die du eher bei billig Browserspielen verwenden willst, aber nicht bei was Ernsthaften. Ja, mit dem Zitat, ja. Kann jeder ein Herr der Ringe erzählerisch starten. Das beruht eben auch auf Erfahrungswerten, wie im Geschichtenschwindung, die spannend zu machen, um die Leute zu binden. Ja. Ja. Ich meine, wenn andere Techniken mehr Mainstream wären oder es ist ja auch so, wie oft wird was gebraucht. Ich denke, sowas wie ein Zitat, wenn das ein, zweimal vorkam, dann war das vielleicht noch was Besonderes und dann hat es vielleicht auch einen guten Bezug auf den Film gehabt. Aber heutzutage kommt mir das so wie Grabbeltischware vor. Was machen wir denn? Wie steigen wir denn ein? Ach, ich suche mal schnell ein Zitat raus. Hat er in 5 Minuten sich was rausgegoogelt, reingeklatscht, fertig. Fertig ist die Laube. und das klingt halt wirklich so, da hat sich keine Gedanken gemacht. Aber wenn es wirklich ein sehr treffendes war, es könnte ja auch sein, dass es ja passend war. Obwohl, das war ein schlechter Witz doch gerade, dieses Zitat mit ich habe hier gleich eine Depression. Ich habe hier gleich hier in meinem Terminkalender steht, dass ich jetzt eine Depression zu haben habe. Das war doch einfach nur ein schlechter Witz, oder? Ich möchte mir das nicht kaputt reden. Nur das schwang nur mit. Ich wollte das nur gerade mitteilen. Gut, schauen wir mal, wie diese Person anfängt. There's nothing as nice as a rainy day. At least it would be a nice day if I were home. It's not nearly as fun. Cooped up here in this car. There's a cloud generator right here. They do anything to get tourists. Still, that ozone smell is one of the best things about this district. Vega sure is taking his time. I wonder if I should go look for him. I'm good here. There he is. He brings the smell of rain inside along with him. Also his cigarette stench soon overwhelms it. What took you so long? Is it serious? He lit up another cigarette, his fourth this morning. Vega doesn't displease me. I can tolerate him way more than the rest of my co-workers. But the smell really gets on my nerves. That woman just kept yammering on. Nothing important. The android. Would you mind putting out the cigarette? It's raining outside. I can't smoke anywhere else. Okay, ich muss drauf achten, wer wird in den Vordergrund gebracht. It's raining outside. I can't smoke anywhere else. Take me home, then. Did you tell the boss? Sure I did. We're done for today. As I was saying, it was just an outdated Android. It didn't support the latest version of HoloNet, so I was giving her trouble. Nee, so it was giving her trouble. Es ist ein Virus, der Zukunft kennt. Nee, hab ich den Bezug zu verloren. tut mir leid. I'd been called for this kind of stuff. When did we turn into HoloNet's on-site tech support? Blame it on the war. Companies have their hands full with all those updates. They need to keep Android safe from hackers. Then they should use old models like I do. I don't get why everyone is obsessed with the new ones. You have to admit, they are charming. People get fond of them. You used to love the new models, or so I've heard. I wonder if he's talking about... No, I don't think so. I know. I thought they were alive, but I grew out of it. I know. It's hard to believe since my first love was an android. Wenn deine erste Liebe ein Android ist, ist der fully customizable? Also, ich sehe da schon so ein bisschen praktischen Nutzen. Oh, come on. Great, it seems like he knows nothing. I will have to make something up. It's true. It was a first generation commercial model, handing out flyers near my house. How could you even like it? I mean, those had most of the wires in plain view, and they didn't even look human at all. I think barely around half of them passed the Turing test. It's embarrassing to think about it now, but I thought all those wires looked cute. I was just a little girl, you know. I guess they were like toys for me. What about families then? How did you plan to have kids with an android? I can't imagine my life now without my two little kids. Vega takes every single chance to boast about his kids and how natural they are. They will probably end up with implants in every nook and cranny soon. So, just like everyone else. I know this might surprise you, but I wasn't exactly planning on having kids when I could still count my age with my fingers. And to this day, having kids still isn't one of my priorities. That's what I thought. Don't you ever feel lonely all by yourself in that shack? Why do you even care? Besides, I'm not alone. I live with my android. Right, your android. You just told me it's an old model. Are you sure that can keep you company? No, it's just there to water my plants. Of course, it's company for me and many more things. Many more things. Thanks, huh? You're not breaking any laws, are you, Zilla? Maybe that attraction for machine wasn't just puppy love after all. He gives me a glance out of the corner of his eye, looking almost haughty. I know he's fishing for a specific answer. It's not like I haven't thought about it before. Having a crush on an android decades ago doesn't mean I want to fuck every single piece of scrap I find. Don't make me regret telling you that. Okay. Jeez, it was a joke. You don't have to get like that. I just wanted to know if... It's shitty company. Are you happy now? Let's just leave it at that. I don't want to talk about it anymore. I knew it. If you ever need to hang out with a flesh and blood person, just tell me. You can have dinner with us. Never in a million years. Sorry. Just think about it, alright? It's important that our group stays healthy and united, you know. What's good for the group? A group is also good for the individual. I know. I've read the manual too. I just don't like family dinners, that's all. Just try to cheer up. I don't want you watching over my back whilst you're moping. Moping? Generell die Unterhaltung finde ich jetzt nicht so verkehrt. Auch wenn ihre Motivation mir jetzt ein bisschen unklar ist, warum sie ihnen Sachen anders gefärbt darstellen will. Und sie eigentlich froh war, dass er keine privaten Details von ihr wusste. So ein bisschen Verdacht unter Kollegen. Oder ist sie vielleicht eine Doppelagentin? Oder irgend sowas? Mal schauen. Again, it was just an automatic medical checkup. So things mess up all the time. Besides, your life is completely different from mine. That's why you don't understand me. Jetzt. Warte mal. Ich würde gerne. Oh! Bonuspunkte für History anschauen. Also alles, was schon mal kam. Warte mal. Okay, wirklich History von ganz am Anfang. Oh, hier habe ich die falsche Stimme. Das war Vega. Da habe ich verwechselt. Okay, ich muss öfter noch auf die Schrift achten. Okay, er hat gesagt, ja, okay, werd fröhlich. Just try to cheer up. I don't want you watching over my back whilst you're moping. Okay. Ja, also sowas, finde ich, ist Grundausstattung im Visual Novels. Dass wenn man mal verwirrt wird von einem Satz, dass man nochmal zurückgucken kann, was war denn vorher. Und im schlimmsten Fall alles nochmal nachlesen kann, was im ganzen Kapitel war. Also, finde ich, ist sehr, sehr wichtig. He hits the nail on the head. My Android isn't exactly the best company. And I have to take care of my health by myself. Still, it's not something I want to talk about with him. You're right. I can't understand you. But I know someone who does. Have you talked with Dala from Velta Labs? Not really. She's weird. Besides, I would rather avoid Velta as much as I can. I spent way too many years of my life with them. I still think you should get to know her. Just because they are working for a big corporation doesn't necessarily mean they are evil. Look at yourself. You're working for an amazing company. Yet you're still a pain in the ass. Very funny. He doesn't come with us often anyway. Actually, she requested to join our unit. I'm going to convince our boss to send her out with us, to try to be friends with her. I can't promise anything. Also prinzipiell, es erinnert mich immer noch an Ghost in the Shell. Da sind die Charaktere halt auch nicht unbedingt freundlich, sondern eher so distanziert, verschwiegen. Aber wenn dann irgendwas passiert, dann sind sie plötzlich so professionell und plötzlich am Witzeln, um ein bisschen Spannungen auch zu reduzieren. Und am Ende merkt man doch, dass diese ganze Attitüde die Bindung einfach zwischen den Leuten darstellt. Und das finde ich nett. Gibt mir gerade dieselben Vibes. Finde ich gut. There's something I don't understand. You don't trust androids. Yet you're really interested in working with them. How exactly did you get into the section? Ist halt ein bisschen zu viel. Der aus Fleisch, die ist halt die Cyborg oder Androiden-affine, sagen wir mal so. Aber selber ist sie ja keine Androide. Mal schauen. Also nicht, dass der dann am Ende nur eine Art Togusa-Ersatz ist. Dann fände ich es schrecklich, wenn das am Ende dann nur heißt, ja, der hat Familie, ist der Ermittler und ansonsten ist er aber ja, nur im Prinzip der Detektiv in der Gruppe, der, sobald es so richtig hart zur Action geht, dann doch eher zurücktreten muss. Und wenn die dann auch im Endeffekt nur ein Major Kusanagi-Verschnitt wird, ich hoffe nicht, das wäre ein Albtraum. mal schauen. Is there something I don't understand? Achso, habe ich schon vorgelesen. Machen wir weiter. The boss is friends with my brother. A croony, really? Ah. Hey, someone had to take the job. And it's not like I'm not qualified. I usually do a competition for those. I had to pass a test. You take any chance you get, and it hasn't been too hard for you either.
I guess.
Get closer to my house. That huge apartment block that reminds me more of a hive than a real home. Vega parks the car in front of my building.
See you tomorrow.
Hey, think about what I said. Go out, take a walk, just don't stay home all day. It's not good for you.
Yeah, yeah.
The building is quiet as ever, something I deeply appreciate. I walk up the concrete stairs leading to my door. I can hear Elaine opening it.
Okay, Moment. So. Damit ich nicht zu sehr meine Stimme strapaziere, habe ich ja billige Hilfsmittel.
Hello, Silla.
Hello.
My day has been great as always. I finished all my tasks in record time. I also cooked the noodles you like.
Weren't we having meat today?
Ah, I forgot to buy it. Sorry.
Okay, is that a random event? Delete that personality feature. I'm going to go change.
Okay. Wie, du hast dir vergessen einprogrammiert? Hör mal damit auf, das mag ich nicht. Okay, gefällt mir.
Sure, bad memory feature eliminated.
I thought I had erased all those random events over the years. To be honest, I end up regretting it every single time. Elaine's ended up as boring piece of scrap, and while that's partly my fault, I can't stand it when she tries to act human-like. I'm done. Elaine, I want to ask you something.
Go ahead.
Doesn't it bother you to erase your own personality little by little?
I'm just doing what you ask me to.
How can you keep me good company then? What if I'm wrong?
My analyzer says that you are healthy, and the odds of incorrect orders are very low. Besides, I always have to follow the orders of a master, unless they require harming another human.
What if all those personality change orders are actually indirectly harming me? Your cult's behavior affecting my mood? Partly. Yes, that's it.
I am not responsible for psychological harm caused to humans due to following their orders.
I know. I just thought your AI was more... whatever. I was just messing with you. Don't worry about it.
I am not. That rule applies strictly to physical damage. My mere existence is enough to harm some humans feelings-wise.
Yeah, yeah.
What's your generation, Elaine?
Second.
You were definitely top of the line back then. You haven't aged too well.
It has been some years since I have had good maintenance. Your food is getting cold. Please let me heat it up a little bit.
Whatever. I'm not hungry. I sit on the couch, turn on the TV, and put on the news. Elaine has always liked to listen to it. I even recall her asking me to let her watch. It's one of her personality features I will never erase. I would hate it even more if she acted completely brainless. Besides, her strict logic comes in handy when I need some explanations.
The Emperor's Parade is currently taking place in Conqueror Square. It seems like the leaders of the Republican Party. Republican Party are absent again.
Don't you think it's strange to have empires and emperors in this age? It's almost anachronistic.
Well, it is a multicultural country in a state of constant expansion ruled by an emperor. I think calling it an empire is correct.
A lot of people love the emperor, if only they knew. Do you know?
Know what?
He's a cyborg.
Is he?
Yes, my team went to the palace once. The Emperor's got a sex android harem, and he himself's half a machine. There's actually a council ruling in the background. They just keep him as the public face.
A harem? Was it not that sex with androids was made illegal?
Sure was, bent by the Emperor himself.
During the parade, three members of the terrorist group White Cat were arrested, all of them veterans from the expansion army.
Seems like there are still some members out there. Do you know them?
They're a terrorist group, right?
Yes. They used to give us a lot of trouble. They've always been very skilled. They are veterans after all. But for some reason, they disappeared.
Did they disappear? Or did someone make them disappear?
My team had a couple of missions and managed to get rid of a few. But it might have something to do with improvements to brain chips. The real threat now are androids, not cyborgs.
Do you think I'm a threat?
Not you, exactly. I mean, androids just generally. You're indeed a threat, and always have been. Androids are just as dangerous for the human race as much as humans themselves. But it doesn't mean we are going to go extinct.
Our law says...
Laws prevent any danger, sure. But those laws are there just because a programmer decided to put them in. Any programmer could make a murderous android. Well, not any programmer, but a really good one could do it.
Yeah.
That's enough. The spending interest feature. I hope I did not hurt you.
Oh, nee, das war sie.
The spending interest feature. Ja, okay.
Also sie hat als Android dann einfach gesagt, ich fahre das runter und Entschuldigung bitte, das Kommando zeigt ihr, dass da was war. Okay. Hurt me. No way. Now let me watch TV. What could have made her ask that question? Maybe it's a security protocol. Hey Elaine, why did you ask if your action hurt me?
I have to look after your health.
Thought so. A factory from the company Smart Movement has been closed after discovering their vehicles were being hacked to drive to the docks, where a body trafficking gang would capture humans and androids alike and take them over to the Yellow Sea. Okay, selbstfahrende Autos. Oh, ganz neue Entführungsmechanismen.
I guess the better team did a lousy job. They shouldn't have let anyone know about the factory closure before getting the traffickers. Now they won't get anyone.
Mr. Johann Schaefer has been declared innocent after the prosecutors failed to prove his ties to the presence of synthetic workers at the bear. Wow, was für Worte. At the Wabenbuch Brussels.
Hypocrites, doing it with a robot must be absolutely wonderful, seeing how popular those Brussels have become. Elaine, would you ever have sex with me? I mean, if you had sex organs.
Well, I have to follow your orders, so I guess I would.
Ban on sexual intercourse is one of the most important laws in New Monks, didn't you know?
Is that why you do not want to upgrade me? Are you thinking of having sexual intercourse with me?
Oh, okay. Warum geht's jetzt eigentlich schon so viel vom Spiel um Sex? Hm?
Of course not. Besides, as I just said, you don't have sexual organs. But with a little imagination.
Do you want me to do something, Scylla? You just have to order it. But I have to remind you if what the law says about it. Nee, of what the law says about it. And even if you have been devoid of affection for quite a while, you could always get it in legal human brothels in the city.
I wasn't suggesting anything. And where did that affection thing come from? Leave me alone.
I see you're upset. Do you want...
Shut up. I clenched my fist to try to calm myself down. It's not the first time she's gotten on my nerves. Every time I try to talk to her, she drives me insane.
It's all right. Tell me if you need anything.
The fast food chain All Days has been forced to close 3 of the restaurants until they are upgraded to serve cyborg meals. The new artificial nutrition law enforces every establishment to serve this kind of meal. This new regulation is also causing big problems for the owners of small businesses who can't afford these new mandatory facilities.
I take some of the noodles Elaine prepared. They are pretty good. Maybe I should thank her for it. But thinking about it, she wouldn't care if I thank her or not. I shouldn't bother.
Parity has shown their new line of women's lingerie. Parity has shown their new line of women's lingerie, ranging from the most suggestive, warum schon wieder dieses Wort, suggestive panties to collars, even a whole new section of robes and bondage attire.
Good memories.
Today, Corbo Industries has launched the new memory chip model. A large amount of students are currently waiting in line in front of the stores to be the first ones to try it. The creator of the chip hopes that, thanks to this, a new era will dawn for Alzheimer patients and students with bad memory. Universal basic income has now been completely implemented in the district of Atlas. This had led to riots in poorer districts as they claim they need that income more than in developed districts. The riots were put to an end by the police a few hours later.
Hours pass as if they were minutes. All the villainous I brought with me was left on my doorstep. As always, the sun comes up and I haven't managed to get a second of sleep. Elaine has been looking at me all night. Again.
Sisters. 14 days before the Synergia incident. Okay, fassen wir mal zusammen. Vorher war das Zitat mit ich habe jetzt eine Stunde Zeit, depressiv zu sein. Oder so. Oder ich habe jetzt einen Termin, in meinem Terminplan steht jetzt, dass ich depressiv sein muss. Irgendwie so. Und natürlich war das jetzt auch nicht die fröhlichste Sache. Also es hat schon so ein bisschen zum Kapitel gepasst. Also es hat gut zum Kapitel gepasst, aber ach, jetzt echt, wird jedes Kapitel so ein scheiß Zitat haben? es war bisher eigentlich ganz gut geschrieben. Ich fand es in Ordnung. Ein paar Stellen dachte ich mir, oh, wie ist da die Formulierung? Komme ich da drüber? Aber das liegt dann eher meine Art vorzulesen. Und ja, also wenn ich es still vor mich hergelesen hätte, hätte ich da, glaube ich, überhaupt nichts zu beanstanden. Schau mal, ist ruhig geworden hier. Also, keine Musik mehr. I get off the couch. Another dose. Was machen denn die Tabletten? Steht nichts dabei. Irgendein, irgendein schönes Molekül. Oh Gott, mir fiel mein Name nicht ein. Okay, bitte.
Elaine, the time?
Good morning, it's 9:15.
Shit, I would better check the holonet.
Did you sleep in again, Zilla? I've been waiting out here 10 minutes.
I'm sorry, I'm coming.
I dress as fast as I can and leave my place without eating breakfast. Vega's in the car, waiting for me in the usual spot.
Can't keep oversleeping every single day, Scylla.
I'm sorry. I will tell them it was my fault.
Pfh. I can't be here to keep you in line all the time. I'm not your father, you know?
I already said I'm sorry. Besides, yesterday we got back to my house very late. It's not my fault I'm not getting enough sleep.
Schon ein bisschen. Ogre Division's in charge of the paperwork today, so we should get back early. This could be our last case together, you know? You've been promoted. I'm getting replaced. I'm sorry, Scylla, but they don't trust you. And I think neither do I.
Are you shitting me? Then what was that whole thing yesterday? Fuck you.
The boss has been informed. Don't worry about it. And if I were you, I would try to change. Things might get bad for you if you don't.
Yeah, what the fuck are you talking about?
Come on, Scylla. You know you're wrong. I'm just trying to help you. I'm getting replaced by that girl I talked to you about yesterday, Darla. You're going to like her.
Verstehe noch nicht so ganz. Okay, sie ist recht distanziert, emotionslos.
Ja. Aber gestern hat er sie eigentlich eingeladen. Komm, komm zu uns privat essen. Hat er gemeint. Aber es war vielleicht keine ehrliche Einladung, weil er ja wusste, dass sie es ausschlagen wird. Gibt ja auch solche unehrlichen Einladungen, dass man so Etikette wahrt, aber in Wirklichkeit denkt, ach, komm bloß nicht.
Okay, you will like her.
So that's what the talk was about. What does he think he is? He can't trust me? What the hell?
Ja, wer hat denn hier wen belogen, ne?
You're an asshole, really. You go around telling me how to live my life, when you're just a bitter family man. So shut the fuck up for once, Viga.
Go on, keep acting as self-centered as you always do. You know I am.
I'm not your daughter, Viga. Go lecture someone else. You don't even know.
Viga slams on the brakes and pulls over. Get out of the car, Scylla.
I can't believe it. The hell I am. This car isn't yours, it's the company's.
But the company put me in charge, so get out of the car. The office is just a few blocks away. Walk it and cool yourself down a bit.
Just start the car again.
Get out of the fucking car, Scylla.
No?
Nur schwarz und ein Mauszeiger. Klick. Okay.
I get out of the car and slam the door shut. I'm still trying to process what's going on. Everything was so sudden. God damn it. A few pedestrians there, but they go back to their routines a few seconds later. I guess I will have to walk to the station. It's kinda cold, and I didn't put on warm enough clothes. I still don't understand why Viga did that. But if he doesn't trust me, then I suppose it's better if he leaves. Now I'm going to have to see him all day, that fucking asshole. I arrive at the building and walk up to the room where the boss is waiting for us. Everyone's in the seats and today's cases have already started to be assigned.
Late again, Scylla.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant. I decide to stand up by the window. I don't really feel like listening to this. He's assigning the cases one at a time, and it doesn't seem like there's anything big today, just as usual. Androids keep getting more reliable. Nothing ever happens inside the borders. Sometimes I wonder if I should enlist in the foreign forces instead.
Scylla? Scylla? So you're not just tardy? You're distracted too?
I am listening, sir.
Ah, I don't have enough time to repeat the whole case all over again. Kyle will tell you all the details in the van.
Kyle?
Viga's replacement.
Ah, I thought that was going to be Darla.
It's complicated. They will explain it to you.
I walk down to the parking lot. The other groups are already leaving. It seems like my new partner is waiting for me in the van. I get inside from the back and try to get comfortable. Are you Kyle?
That's right.
Where's Darla?
She couldn't come. She's joining us in a few days.
Is Viga coming with us?
He's no longer part of your unit, so he went to the side in his own car. From now on, we will be using the van.
I get it. Whatever, tell me about the mission.
It's a married couple. The woman, Christine, is 40 years old and the man, Felix, is 43. The woman called a few hours ago, claiming the android had taken her husband hostage. Husband hostage. They are locked in the bedroom, and the android refuses to let him go. There aren't any records or proof of purchase for this android, so I suspect it might have come from the black market. That's probably the source of the problem.
It's gonna be hard to deal with an unregulated android, especially if they are strong enough to kidnap an adult man. So, what's your role here?
Back up. I'm covering your rear with my rifle.
And why do I even need a sniper?
Safety. Everyone needs a sniper for safety. Yeah, yeah.
I can't help but notice that Veltalab's logo on his arm. He works with them too, just like Dana. Hey, why am I getting grouped up with Veltalab mercenaries?
Dana's going to explain it to you tomorrow. Don't worry, we are not mercenaries.
Sure. After a few minutes of silence, we arrive at the building. It's a fairly standard apartment complex. Kyle gets on the rooftop of the building in front and stands guard from there. I take the elevator to the floor where the couple lives. Vigi and a few other agents are already there, talking to the woman. Who is that?
The specialist. She's going to deal with the android.
Isn't she way too young? No, I'm not, and I need you to elaborate on this whole situation.
Didn't Kyle already explain it to you? The android locked it
okay, vierte. Och man, ich hätte auf sein Gesicht achten sollen. Das ist ja gar nicht Kyle. Oh, das ist wieder Vega. Okay. Und seine neue Partnerin, jetzt verstehe ich's.
Didn't Kyle already explain it to you? The android locked itself in with the husband as his hostage. That's it.
Ich merke gerade, hier fehlt irgendwie die halbe Strumpfhose. Gott, also... Als wäre die gerade aus der Disco geflogen oder... ich weiß nicht. Als wäre sie überfallen worden. Ja, vielleicht eher so.
Did it do it for a specific reason? Perhaps something happened?
None that I know.
I'm asking her. No, it's never acted like that before. It's got to be broken.
How strange.
So, where did you buy it?
Ah, ist nicht seine Partnerin, das ist einfach die Frau, der Mann gefangen genommen ist. Okay.
It was such a long time ago. I don't remember anymore.
Schwache Ausrede.
Sure. Does it ever go outside? Of course not.
Why not?
It just doesn't like it.
Cut the crap. We're going through that door sooner or later and check on that android.
You don't want to cooperate with us? That's on you.
Zilla, the curtains are closed, but I can see them with the heat sensor. Man's laying on the bed, still alive, and the android's right by the door, listening to you. Child's hate, so that they seem to confirm it's an illegal android.
Oh, vielleicht so eine Art Kunsttochter oder so? Hm.
So tell me, Christine, are you or your husband infertile? What kind of question is that?
Her face flushes as soon as I ask the question. You're definitely not going to help me. I should try to work with the android.
I get close to the door.
Oh, Auswahl!
Try to connect directly to the android. Risky, but I don't have too many options. That woman wasn't helping me at all. It's too risky to get any kind of connection with a black market android. I should try to convince him the old way.
Ja, reden wir erstmal.
What's the android's name, miss? Jim.
Oh, little Jimmy. Did you name him?
I'm trying not to laugh. Yes, why do you need to know? It's important for communication. Okay, Jim, can you hear me? Now! Jim, according to the laws of robotics, blah blah blah, you cannot harm any humans.
Hey, be serious.
So, that's it. Open the door so we can reprogram you. You won't leave either way, whether you open it or not. But if you don't, we will have to force our way in. With everything that applies. Black market androids have no rights.
Black market?
Ask the lady. I don't know what you're talking about.
The android's acting strange. He's moving away from the door. Ah, ich merke gerade, dass sie sich hier angeschlossen hat.
You're not exactly like they told me, Scylla.
Eh? How do you know my name?
I've been looking for you for a while. I have a message for you. I need to give it to you in person.
What the fuck?
Okay, then open the door and give it to me. Ah, no, no. It's not the kind of message you can touch. I need you to connect to the building network, and then I will send it to your memory chips.
If you think I'm gonna let you do that, dream on.
The door doesn't seem to be particularly strong. Maybe I could take it down using the prosthetics. If you insist. I see the doorknob twisting, and here's a latch moving. And then a gunshot coming from outside. It's Kyle. I hit the doorknob with my left arm and open the door. The man is sitting on the bed, trapped between the bed metal posts. And just as I thought, the android had no security limits.
The android was getting close to the hostage. I had to shoot.
What the hell was that, Scylla? I told you, you weren't doing well. What a shitty shop. If you ever do something like this again...
What are you talking about? It was the new guy who called the shot. The android was just opening the door. You saw it too. You messed up. Just take the blame and tell the boss. And for goodness sake, get some help.
Am I the only one who doesn't get it? How can they blame me for that?
And also, what kind of programming was that?
The android knew my name.
Maybe he was being controlled through the network?
We should have cut off the connection.
I contact my boss through HoloNet. Ah, zum Glück, die Musik war schon ein bisschen nervig.
Lieutenant, we have saved the hostage, but the android was destroyed. Kyle blew his brain out, without my permission. I don't think we'll be able to retrieve any information on the hacker. The security protocols probably wiped the hard drive as soon as the android was damaged. But maybe they can find something in the lab.
It was a good idea to send Kyle with you. It seems like what Vega reported to me was true. You're not in top shape. I'm sure he was forced to do it. Ich verstehe jetzt auch nicht, was ist. Also wir kriegen irgendwie eine verfremdete Wahrnehmung. Alle anderen sehen was anders? Oder genau, alle anderen sind gehackt und kriegen das nicht mit.
Sir, you don't understand. There was no reason for...
I hope it was just a mistake. Don't do it again.
It was a mistake, boss. It won't happen again.
Scylla, Hoplon Zack is not just another private security firm. The state has put the district safety in our hands, and it's our duty to not fail.
But I didn't fail, sir. The hostage is safe.
And his creators know getting off scot-free thanks to your irresponsibility.
And his creators know getting...
Okay, Moment, nee, unter Options war's. Runter, runter, runter. Viel, viel Text. The hostage is safe and his creators now getting off screen. Also ich weiß schon, dass er auf den Roboter sich bezieht. Oder auf den Androiden. Seltsame Folge. Na gut. Passt zumindest so kontextmäßig nicht. Synerg, ja. 21 Followers, Twitch.
Ja, deshalb bin ich auch unter Games und Demos. Da in Synergie würde mich niemand finden. Keine Ahnung, ob Games und Demos jemand vorbeischaut, aber ja, man müsste sich irgendwie in mehr Kategorien, zum Beispiel eine Grundkategorie Visual Novel wäre auch schon mal was, dass ich mich in die Grundkategorie eintragen kann, dann vielleicht Grundkategorie Cyberpunk, Grundkategorie was hätte man denn noch Schönes? Robotics. Oder vielleicht so Art Thriller, könnte ich mir auch vorstellen, dass es ist. Und dann halt noch das Spiel an sich. Aber ja. Generell, wie findet man Streams? Das ist ja alles zufallsbasiert. Okay, ich lese mal hier raus vor, weil ich habe das vorhin aus Versehen weggeklickt. And his creator's now getting off scot-free, thanks to your responsibility. Now you definitely failed, Scylla. You've disappointed me and your whole district. Now go home and don't bother coming back tomorrow. I don't want you here until Darla is working too. And don't forget, this will show up on your paycheck. It wasn't my fault. Did I make myself clear? Don't let it happen again. Understood, sir. Clench my jaw and hang up. I'm getting out of here. Farewell and good riddance, Scylla. I wish you luck. Goodbye, take care of the rest. I have to get back on the train. At least I can take a look at the city I'm supposed to protect. Chance ist größer. Games und Demos 724.000 Follower, ja. Generell, ich meine, ich erinnere mich jetzt gar nicht, wann habe ich zuletzt eine Kategorie gebrowst? Also ich gebe hin und wieder mal einen Tag ein und suche nach einem Tag. Aber dass ich ein Spiel eingebe und danach suche, eigentlich nicht. In Games und Demos gucke ich eigentlich auch nicht rein. Also ich schaue die Startseite, was wird mir jetzt vorgeschlagen? Und ansonsten schaue ich meine 40, 50 Followers. Ich habe wahrscheinlich viel mehr, nicht Followers, denen ich follow an. Also ich klicke im Prinzip immer wieder mal in Vorschläge rein, wo ich denke, oh, der wird mir vorgeschlagen. Oh, sieht nett aus. Habe ich erst gestern oder vorgestern Dead Space jemanden spielen sehen. Das wurde mir vorgeschlagen, weil ich habe halt Dead Space gestreamt. Und ist auch ein kleiner Streamer. Och, irgendwas mit Zwerg. Der Spielezwerg, der Gaming-Zwerg. Bin mir nicht ganz sicher. War sympathisch, kam rüber, hat mit mir interagiert. Der hat nette Leute im Chat gehabt. Er verzweifelte ein bisschen, wie er sich da durchschießen wollte. Aber das war auch spaßig anzugucken. Follow da gelassen. Ich habe irgendwie mal die Hoffnung, dass ich bei ihm reinreden kann. Oder zumindest hin und wieder mal ihn anhaben kann. Wenn mal eine laue Stunde ist und andere Streamer nicht da sind. Also so finde ich andere Leute. Also über Kategorie sehr, sehr selten. Boah, aber ich habe schon lange nicht mehr gesucht. Also ich bin zurzeit recht gesättigt, was Konsum von Twitch-Streams angeht. Also ich habe so meine Leute, wo ich reingucke. Und bewege mich immer im selben Dunstkreis. Das ist... Da muss man hin und wieder mal ausbrechen raus, ja. I have to get back on the train. At least I can take a look at the city I'm supposed to protect. Beziehungsweise ihr könnt mir helfen, aus diesem Dunstkreis auch auszubrechen, weil ihr kennt ja auch andere Leute und ihr könnt immer wieder mal einen Raid-Vorschlag geben, wo ich dann im Anschluss hinraiden kann. Aber das ist halt auch nur bedingt möglich. Also es ist nicht immer unbedingt jemand on, wenn ich gerade zu Ende bin. Aber auf die Art kann man halt Tipps geben. Oder auch gerne im Discord. Hätte ich auch nichts dagegen, wenn einer meint, hey, hier ist ein cooler Streamer, könnte mal reinnehmen. Aber sollte ich das vielleicht markieren, oder? Das schreibe ich mal auf. Oh, ich komme gerade jetzt so ein bisschen auf den Trichter. Ich könnte ja extra mal ein Channel machen, wo man einfach andere Streamer vorschlägt. Streamer-Vorschläge im Discord. Bei mir reicht es oft, einfach mal ein VOD anzugucken. Und dann sage ich mir, okay, VOD wirkt sympathisch, folge ich einfach mal. Und dann schaue ich halt rein, wenn er mal live ist. Oder sie live ist. Streamer-Vorschläge im Discord. Okay. Oh, bin ich die Nachtschicht oder wie? Ich dachte immer, ich bin noch gerade so der Abendausklang und dann erst kommt die Nachtschicht. So. I have to get back on the train. At least I can take a look at the city I'm supposed to protect. This shithole. Even the most upscale neighborhoods are corrupt to the core. Sometimes I wonder why I'm still in this place. I don't care about it. I don't like my co-workers, I don't get paid well, I guess it's just all I have. Well, Zed and Elaine, and I don't know which one is worse. Zitat. Das letzte Zitat habe ich mir nicht gemerkt. Ah, ja. Okay. Marie Curie starb an Krebs, oder? Ich glaube schon. Half an hour of walking and I'm absolutely wrecked. I thought I was in better shape. I've got to start working out again. My protocells have gotten lazy. Anyway, so far this day has been absolutely horrible. I just hope Elaine behaves. How strange. She's not waiting on the doorstep for me. Maybe her day was too busy and she's still working. Or it could be a feature I still haven't deleted. Könnte jemand mal gucken, wie viele Kapitel die Geschichte hat, damit ich einen guten Break setzen kann? Weil wenn ich weiß, jetzt bin ich im dritten Zitat, das heißt, ich bin jetzt im Kapitel 3. Und wenn ich weiß, es gibt 20 Kapitel, dann würde ich so bei 10 versuchen, einen Abschluss hinzubekommen. Also dann würde ich 10 noch zu Ende spielen. Und dann würde ich den Rest auf nächste Woche. Wenn ich gesagt bekomme, es gibt 6 Kapitel, dann werden die heute einfach durchgespielt. Dann ist es, also jetzt von der Info nicht so wichtig, aber prinzipiell habe ich jetzt keinen Schimmer, welche Richtung die Geschichte geht. Und diese Zitate haben den Vorteil, die markieren im Prinzip so einen Kapitelübergang. Da könnt ihr aber mal schauen, falls jemand die Muse hat. Ansonsten schaue ich vielleicht ein bisschen später, so nebenher mal. Wenn ich meine, ich müsste mal aufhören. How strange, she's not waiting on the doorstep. Okay, schauen wir weiter. Elaine, are you here? I don't know why I'm yelling. This flat barely 300 square feet. I enter and turn on the lights. Elaine is right there, sitting on the couch. Weißt du, die Batterien leer? Hey, Elaine, why aren't you replying? Elaine? I get closer to her. She's turned off. But it's not her battery, she would have told me. I connect to her through my spirit. Spirit? Through my spirit. I almost forgot I have to use it to manually connect to the whole net. I turn her back on.
Hello, please insert a memory disk in the artificial intelligence V3.0 pod.
Elaine, what are you talking about? What happened? Why did you turn off? He's not responding. Shit. That's just what I needed. I hope everything's fine and it was just a crash. I need to take a look. Jetzt ist sie der Nächste, der gehackt ist. I go grab my toolbox. Elaine's pretty old. She shouldn't be too hard to fix if her pieces are fine. If I can't, I highly doubt I can afford to get her fixed. The hardware for these models was discontinued years ago. I use a screwdriver to open the latch that covers her brain. When I pull in on it, my hands get stained by a sticky fluid. It seems to be everywhere. What the hell is this? It's definitely not rust. I take the pieces out one at a time and clean them up with a rag. After that, I cover her processor with thermal paste and connect everything. All her parts are in good shape, so I assume the strange fluid was the cause of the problem.
is ready to boot again, so I run my Spirit. Elaine? Elaine? Ups. Oh, cool! Ich habe gerade gemerkt, ich kann mit dem Rädchen vor und zurück. Nur in die Vergangenheit. Okay, aber es gibt wohl so Seen, der braucht ein bisschen. Entschuldigung, ich gehe gleich wieder vor. Und anscheinend kann ich nur zu denen, wo ich schon war. Das heißt, ich kann nicht über das Ziel hinausschießen. Das ist cool. Elaine?
Hi, thank you for choosing Mente, the best artificial intelligence company. Nice to meet you. I am starting up the system. Please stand by. This process could take several minutes.
Oh, sie darf sie neu einrichten. Eine KI neu versauen.
What do you mean, starting up? No, no, no!
Please give me your ownership card.
Elaine, load up the latest backup. You're not just dumb. No, you're deep too. Just load it up, you piece of junk.
I run to my desk to search for my card. After 5 minutes of digging through garbage, I managed to find it. I almost trip on the way back. I didn't know I cared about Elaine so much. I hand her the card. There you go.
Nice to meet you, Scylla. Starting today, I will be your service android and will help you with any task you need.
Yeah, yeah, just load up your latest backup.
Starting up personality features. Scylla, what is my name?
Ah, Elaine, your name's Elaine.
Perfect, that is a great name. I'm ready for my first task or task list.
Finally, load your latest backup.
There are currently no backups on my database.
What? No. How can this happen? Tell me the date of the oldest entry in your database.
The oldest is right now.
It's gone. All her data has been lost. It was somewhat cold before. I know her personality is no different than any other android. Everything has been lost. Elaine died in her own way, while I was gone.
Deactivate all your features and wait on the doorstep until I give you orders.
Are you sure you want to deactivate 6842 features? I might become a bit boring.
Yes, I'm sure.
Elaine leaves and stands in the doorstep, waiting. Tja. I stay on the couch with a blank stare. Why is this happening to me? Does that hacker have something to do with this? No, it couldn't be that. Elaine didn't even have access to the network. I've ended up completely alone. What do I do now? I don't want to spend the rest of my life like this. I know that. Will I get some human friends? No, that's not an option. My holonet sounds. I have a call. It's Yoko. I haven't had a good talk with her in ages. I walk up to my desk and connect my Spirit.
Yo, I hope I ain't bothering you.
Hi, Yoko. No, I wasn't doing anything.
Hey, Scylla. Sorry for not being around lately. I'm kinda busy, but I'm free now. Just saw your message.
A message? I don't know what you're talking about.
Hang on. Let's just use our avatars.
Okay. What, Vibo? Inbox. Blon. Nee, ich möchte jetzt nicht viel. Connectus Holonet, ja.
I connect to Holonet's virtual session and close my eyes.
Okay, ich habe jetzt was anderes erwartet. Ich habe jetzt irgendwie, dass sie wirklich anders aussehen, aber was ist jetzt
Okay, jetzt sind sie im selben Raum. Virtuell im selben Raum. Alles gut. Jetzt haben sie sich in Meta eingeloggt. Also so, wie es die Woche präsentiert wurde. Ich habe die Präsentation nicht gesehen. Also ich habe da nur Gerüchte so an mir vorbeifliegen sehen. Also so einzelne Bilder, Schnappschüsse. Also nicht wirklich, was jetzt Meta macht. Kein VR-Chat. Also ich hätte jetzt erwartet, dass man andere Avatare sieht und nicht sich selber in Person. Ich meine, als kalte Person könnte Links ja einfach nur der schwarze Obelisk von 2001 sein. Und rechts könnte irgendwie eine Comicfigur oder irgendeine überdrehtes Hipstermädchen erscheinen. Oder von mir aus hat sie halt auch einen männlichen Avatar. Aber das ist jetzt wirklich unkreativ von den beiden. Aber sie sind im selben Raum halt. I'm next to Yoko now.
Tell me, what up?
You were the one who called me?
Ah, you sent me a message a few hours ago saying Elaine was broken.
I didn't send anything.
Maybe it was an automatic message. Elaine was a corpo model, right? I work with them.
It's impossible. Elaine wasn't connected to the net. Maybe it was a hacker?
The one from this morning?
I don't know, Zilla. You're the one always getting into the other brains, not me. Whatever, get your ass to my store. I got new models, and there's one I think you will be really into.
I can't just let it go. And I don't even know if I want another android. I don't have the money to spare.
Oh, come on, that thing was ancient, weren't it? Don't worry about the money. It won't cost you a cent.
Do you think it's a good idea to just replace Elaine?
Wait, for free? Who are you and what did you do to the real Yoko? I know you tend to grow fond of androids, but Elaine was just metal and plastic, nothing else. It ain't a suggestion. You're coming here to see me and that's it.
It's not like I have better things to do, but I already warned you I'm not going to buy anything. And what about you? How is everything going?
Great, Zilla. I've got to go. Stuff came up. Come to the store tomorrow and we'll talk, okay? See you tomorrow.
Wait, you're just leaving like that? She hung up. I opened my eyes.
Also das klingt schon sehr getürkt. Also entweder haben wir Gedächtnisverlust und wir agieren immer nebenher. Und kriegen es nicht mit. Wir haben ja auch ein bisschen Schlafmangel, hieß es. Also vielleicht wurden wir auf einer ganz anderen Ebene gehackt und machen Dinge, die andere um uns herum mitbekommen. Oder aber jemand hat es vorbereitet und Yoko war nicht Yoko.
I'm in my room again. I would better go to sleep. I don't know if it's going to be easy to buy another android. And that message. Could it be Yoko's just pranking me?
Einfach nur für diesen Übergang. 13 days before the Synergia incident. War ja immer noch was. Suddenly constitutes bad news when people who agree with you are bigger than... Buggier sind bad. Warte. Hört mir doch mit den Zitaten auf. Einfach. Aber ich schau mal kurz nach, wie viele dieser Kapitel es gibt. Ich muss mal kurz. So. Synergia. How many chapters? Bisher gefällt es mir. Wirklich. Also die Dialoge sind okay. Die sind nicht auf einem Niveau, wir erzählen einfach mal alles so direkt wie möglich. Also es lässt mich ein bisschen rätseln, finde ich gut. Und die Persönlichkeit vom Hauptcharakter kommt einigermaßen gut rüber. Ich möchte keine Game-Reviews, ich möchte einfach nur wissen, wie viele Kapitel. Ah, kann ich einfach Chapter-Titles? Synergia, Chapter-Titles. Dann kriege ich vielleicht Section-Title. Klingt auch gut. So, Namen Sui. alles schön bunt färben hier. Was haben wir denn? Outsider Protege, Third Machine, Breaking Web, Iron Fist, The God, The Mind. Ah ne, das sind die Achievements. Ne, ich will keine Achievement-Liste. Ich möchte Energie-Kapitel-Liste haben. Energie-Chapters, dann halt einfach nur. Ja, habe ich ein paar eingebundene. Ich muss mir noch ein paar ausdenken und dann auch mal die Zeit investieren. Ich suche gerade, wie viele Kapitel hat dieser Visual Novel, damit ich so weiß, wie viel ich durchzuspielen habe. YouTube-Video perfekt. Na toll, das schaue ich mir jetzt nicht nebenher an. Ich möchte einfach nur die Kapitelliste haben. Top Similar Games. Walkthrough ist ja auch irgendwie. Aber vielleicht kriege ich in einem Walkthrough die Kapitel. Natürlich nur Videos. All Endings. Endings sind mir egal. Ich mache meinen Run und fertig. Trophy, Game Database. Ich möchte. Okay, ich mache einfach weiter und schaue, wie weit es mich trägt. Und dann muss ich halt ein Spiel für nächste Woche vorbereiten, falls Synergie doch nicht so zu Ende kommt. Ah, das ist nichts Automatisches. Okay, da muss ich sogar agieren. Gehen wir mal kurz raus dann. Zack. Und wo haben wir es? Da. So, Tag X, 22.11. Schauen wir mal. Wir haben 1. Dezember, 27., 25., 22. Oh, ein langes. Wilhelm Busch. Der 22. November ist wohl Tag der Hausmusik. Und... Upsi. Upsi. Ich bin verwirrt. Okay, genau, Wilhelm Busch, gemartert. Ein gutes Tier ist das Klavier, still, friedlich und bescheiden, und muss dabei doch vielerlei erdulden und erleiden. Der Virtuos stürzt darauf los, mit hochgesträubter Mähne, eröffnet ihm voll Ungestüm den Leib gleich der Hyäne, und rasend wild das Herz erfüllt von mörderlicher Freude, durchwühlte dann, soweit er kann, des Opfers ein Geweide. Wie es da schrie, das arme Vieh, und unter Angstgewimmer, bald hoch, bald tief, um Hilfe rief, vergesse ich nie und nimmer. Also es geht um ein Klavier eigentlich, was auseinander oder gestimmt wird. Ich find's gut. Hast dir ein schön großes rausgesucht? Ich find's gut. Okay. und ich war jetzt immer noch nervös mit dem Upsi, ob ich den Stimmverzerrer anhabe oder so. So, kann man abhaken. Okay, 6 bis 9 Stunden. Danke nochmal. How Long to Beat habe ich vergessen, dass ich da auch nachschauen könnte. Das Dumme ist, die gehen ja davon vom stillen Lesen. Also heißt, ich spiele einfach soweit mich meine Stimme trägt. Und vielleicht, bis ich eine schöne Stelle habe, wo vielleicht ein Cliffhanger ist oder wo gerade irgendwas abgeschlossen ist. Wie zum Beispiel irgendeine Enthüllung, die dann kommt. Und ja, dann lasse ich mich jetzt nicht weiter davon blenden, dass ich es heute fertig bekomme. Weil es wird heute wahrscheinlich eh nicht fertig. 6 Stunden, würde ich nie schaffen dann. Okay. So, it's high noon. There isn't a better feeling in the world than waking up knowing you don't have to work. And that vanished once I remembered I have to go to Yuko's store. I wasn't excited about it yesterday. But today I feel kinda nervous. I don't even know why. Let's go, Elaine. Come with me.
Yes, Zilla.
I take a floating train to Yuko's neighborhood, and it's one of the district's richest areas, right on the border to the next one. As I walk up, it seems she just opened and no one else appears to be inside. Ooh. Keine männlichen Modelle. Dankeschön. Ist jetzt leider im Lurk. Nee, danke für den Lurk auch und danke fürs kurze Reinschauen. Es ist schwer reinzufinden bei sowas. Generell weiß ich noch nicht, ob ich eine Zusammenfassung machen soll, aber wenn einer gerade dazukommt und gerne hören mag, was ist, versuche ich es zusammenzufassen. Aber noch ist noch nicht so viel passiert, dass ich meine, nicht einfach mit dem Flow zu gehen. Ja. Was habe ich denn wieder gesagt? Skandal? Achso, dass hier jemand in den Lurk geht. Ach, du willst, dass ich in dieser Form, dass ich so weiter streame oder wie? Oder, achso, du meinst das. Nee, okay, war ich jetzt zu selbstverliebt. Nee, jedenfalls. Keine männlichen Modelle, ja, Skandal. Obwohl, da gibt es einen Samurai, aber der hat auch Brüste. Nee, also ist eine Samuraiin. Ah, okay. Versucht man zu interpretieren. Okay. Hi, Yuko. Zilla, you finally came. Yuko gives me a gigantic hug as soon as she sees me. I actually feel glad to see her as well. Ever since her therapy started, we have been barely able to see each other anymore. She still wears that weird red scarf, so I assume she's still part of that bike gang. Why don't we put this one back in her box, you hear me? That way we can talk for a bit. Alright, I still can't believe she broke after all these years. Elaine, follow Yuko. Yuko takes Elaine to the back of the store and turns the offices pirate. After that, she puts her inside a pot along with my ownership card. I think this will be the last time I will see Elaine. Oh, Moment, drei männliche Modelle. Ha, okay, das ist doch gemischt. Aber, na, weiß nicht. Gut, mit dem kann man vielleicht noch ein bisschen was anfangen. Nee. Oh. Don't you have any customers? I don't want to bother you. Meh, whatever. You always bother me. In any case, you always bother me. Das ist nicht das Übliche, wie man auf jemanden reagiert, oder? Ich möchte dich nicht stören. Ach, du störst mich immer. Andererseits, wenn sie gute Freunde sind, dann wird's passen, sowas. In any case, this place ain't just another store, you know. I don't get too many customers, especially at this time of day. Fine, then how are you doing? Do you mean how I'm doing in general, the business or the therapy? Everything, I guess. The shop is going well, like always. We get new models and sell them fast. I spend most of my time here working and with the gang.
Are you still with them? I don't get how they haven't gotten you yet. Are you still with them? I don't get how they haven't gotten you yet.
Ach so, Sam ist es nicht die Gang, sondern dass sie halt keine Ahnung, sind Sprayer oder Gelegenheitshacker und hacken gerne die Süßigkeitenautomaten in der Gegend. Keine Ahnung, was so eine Gang macht. Ich habe da recht unschuldige Vorstellungen wahrscheinlich. Und dass sie noch nicht von der Polizei erwischt wurden. Ja.
Because you're crooked, that's why. And I don't get into too much trouble anymore. I just go out to drive with them and do a thing or two. If you want someone to discover me, then you gotta be the one arresting me. I just take care of androids, you know that. Also, thinking about it, you're barely human anymore. I'm still legally human, and about the therapy, I'm a lot better now. It's hard considering the kind of business I run, but I haven't put anything new in myself for months. I feel a lot more stable. I'm glad it was harming you. You were turning into a psycho. I mean, more than before at least. Human bodies ain't ready for extremely sudden changes, or that's what the shrink said. Anyway, I'm glad you're not turning into a killer robot. I'm glad too. I liked that whole killer cyborg thing. What's the way you need a new android, right? By the way, you need a new android, right? Always right to business. I have problems too. I'm fucked. More like I'm getting fucked over. And then Elaine broke. So, yeah. Have I gotten beat up anyone?
Was? Have I gotten beat up? Achso. Sie sagt, ja, wen kann ich für dich verprügeln?
It's my job. I think they are trying to fire me. Nee, it's my job. I think they are trying to fire me. They blame me for everything that goes wrong and change my partners. I'm sure they are just looking for a reason. Bah, don't worry about it. You can always work for me.
What a relief.
Let's check out the android I told you about that will cheer you up. I don't have money for a new android. It don't matter, follow me. Okay.
Yoko guides me to the shelves area. Different models are sorted into sections, each one showcasing a few types. But half of them are female and seem kinda bland, to be honest. There's mehr als die Hälfte female.
All of these androids are too average, I don't care about them.
Should I really be doing this? Maybe living alone would be better.
There's something I don't like about having to buy a friend.
Kannst dir doch Katzen kaufen.
I don't know if I want another robot, honestly. Androids have been bugging me for a while. It's their fake personalities. Look at that one!
Yoko moves some models out of the way, showing a pot in the back of the shelf. This one's different. She's in a life pod, without any kind of liquid. She has an oxygen tube connected to her neck, and only the latest generation androids use those.
A bioroid? Yep. And is that supposed to be some kind of new model? Yes or no, the model's new and ain't for sale. Completely finished, but still in the final testing process. This one is actually second hand. She's had a few owners before.
Really? You're selling me a second-hand android?
It's exactly cause she's second-hand that I ain't selling her. I said it before, she's not for sale. And don't ask me about her previous owner or how I got her. I can't answer that.
And they won't track the android? I'm going to trust you. I hope you don't get me into trouble.
So I take it you're interested.
It's free, isn't it?
Of course I am. Great, the android is ready, and no, nobody ain't gonna track her. Just don't let her connect to the network unsupervised, just in case. Her old name was Mara, but you can change it if you want.
Mara, I like it.
Good, I will send her to your place in a few minutes.
Don't you need my card?
Zilla, I know your info already, you know?
I have a bad feeling about this.
Oh well, I will be off home then. You're in a hurry? I want to try her. Well then, have fun. Hit me up on Holonet if she starts doing anything weird or breaks down. Alright? Yeah, yeah. Thank you, Yoko. Take care. Thinking back on it, the android had earrings. Her old owner most likely gave them to her, and Yoko should have taken them off. There's still something a bit off about all this. How was Yoko supposed to sell that android? I don't think she's the one responsible for Elaine's breakdown. Yoko's twisted, but not that much.
Okay, ich vermute, weil irgendjemand es auf sie abgesehen hatte, also sie speziell über einen Androiden kontaktet hat, dass Yoko ein logischer Zweitkontakt wäre, weil die ist umringt von Androiden und man könnte ja im Prinzip Yoko ein bisschen eingeschüchtert haben, dass sie dafür sorgt, dass Mara zu Sela rübergeht. Das ist meine Vermutung momentan.
Anyway, I have a new android and thinking about it, Elaine didn't really keep me company, so I can't complain. I arrive at my flat, but the capsule's nowhere to be found. Maybe I got here before the package.
Er hat sich selbst ausgepackt.
I head inside. The couriers are as efficient as ever, so I guess I will have to wait. I hear a knock on my door. Is it the package? I run to open it, but choose to look through the peephole first.
Ah, sie hat sich selbst geliefert.
There's a girl waiting. It's the android. It's beautiful. But why is her hair white? It's got to be a test model. She didn't even dye her hair.
Vielleicht. So.
Hello.
She looks scared. I open the door for her. She ducks under my arm and gets inside my apartment. Hey, I'm...
Sela. I mean, Sela. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. You're probably Mara. I just thought...
I'm Mara. Yes, so this is your house?
Yeah, it's my house. Hey, why didn't you come here in your pod?
Ooh, why?
I take my card from my pocket and hand it to her. It doesn't seem like she knows what to do with it.
What's this?
It's my ownership card.
Owner? Ah, of course. Yoko sold me. I almost forgot.
Yeah, I just bought you. Wait, you know Yoko? I don't get it. She remember Yoko? You probably started her up at the store and forgot to wipe her memory. Classic Yoko.
Eh, she finally did it, so I'm your roommate now.
Well, I bought you, so I guess.
Yoko said she wouldn't sell me, so I guess she changed her mind. I'm glad she did.
Did you want to get sold? Hang on, wait. First of all, why are you already booted up?
Why shouldn't I be?
Whatever. What did Yoko say about me?
Nothing in particular.
Can I know why you still have memories? Didn't they wipe them before putting you up for sale?
Of course I have memories. Memories of my old family and Yoko. Thoughts they are kinda blurry. I've never had a good memory. Got that from my sister.
How strange. Maybe I shall call Yoko.
Now I'm going to live here. It's a lot better than the warehouse.
I think this is a special thing she mentioned. An android with memories. I guess she thought that would give her a bigger personality. I'm not sure if I like it. Hey, you know what? Your hair color reminds me of something that happened to me the other day. Mara makes a puzzled face.
Uh-huh.
I saw a food stand. They were selling a strange candy I had never seen before. It's called cotton candy. Cotton like the one used for clothes. Could it be that your hair is made with the same substance?
What stupidity? How is it going? Wait a minute, did you just try to Turing test me?
I must have hit the nail on the head because you seem upset.
I'm not going to fall for that trick.
Well, I didn't expect you to catch me so fast.
You didn't even try.
Mara smiles, proud of herself. Honoria was just testing the waters. There's one thing I would like to ask you. You are Bioroid, are you not?
I don't really know what a Bioroid is.
An android made of organic materials. Have you ever cut yourself, Lev?
I think I've cut myself before, yes. And I definitely bled.
That's not really nice to know if you're a Bioroid, but I'm still pretty sure you are. I'm curious how you see the world.
What do you mean?
Do you see any kind of information that human beings can't see?
And how am I supposed to know that? I've never seen the world through the eyes of a human being. In fact, I've never seen anything through anything other than my own eyes.
Has your brain always been inside that body?
Wait. Would you stop with that testing? I know what you're doing.
Test? Damn it, she really is perceptive. She got me again.
I had a lot of tests when... You know, forget it. Just stop asking me weird questions.
What's this about having a lot of tests? Tell me.
No, it's not something I want to talk about.
Tell me, it's an order.
No.
What? You can't refuse.
I'm refusing right now.
This android, it's something very peculiar. It answers in very unique way to all the tests I do, and it doesn't seem to follow any kind of laws or rules. Maybe it's from the black market. If that's the case, Yoko could have just put me in a good mess with... Yoko could have just put me in a good mess by selling it to me.
Hello, I'm still here.
So how did you get here exactly? You weren't in any capsule, so I guess you came by your own. I don't get it. You were in the support before you left the store.
Support mistakenly arrived at one of the upper floors of the building. A girl dressed in red woke me up there and walked me to your door.
A girl in red? You could be one of Yoko's cronies. And why sent Mara to another floor? Maybe it was a mistake after all. I didn't give her my details. You must have forgotten. No, that girl already knew that the capsule was going to reach the upper floor. Why do that on purpose then? That's weird. Did she tell you her name?
No, and the truth is that I was a little dizzy, so I didn't ask her either. In fact, I'm still a little dizzy. I've barely had a glimpse of the city that girl was shoving me down.
Well, now you're here. Honestly, I don't know what to do with you. I guess I will figure it out later.
What do you mean by that?
Don't worry about it. And you will see the city soon enough.
If you say so, at least can you show me around?
It's getting late, so I think I will go to sleep.
Late? It just got dark. Ah, of course, you are a cop.
It's the pills, but yeah, how did you know?
I saw your badge on the uniform lying there.
Right, well then, I'm going to sleep.
I'm going to sleep too. Please wake me up tomorrow. I don't want to end up sleeping all day. I got more than enough sleep in that pot. Wake you up? Sleep? Or do I say this? You're a machine. You can't just log off.
Ah, vertan. Mist. Na gut, dann nochmal.
Weiter. I don't think I know how to do that.
You don't even know how to turn yourself off?
What's wrong with sleeping with you?
Do you see that thing on the floor? That's my bed. I sleep on a futon.
Well, I can sleep on a futon too. My back might hurt a little bit in the morning, but I can live with it.
I don't think you understand. I don't have another futon, so you're going to sleep on the couch.
I will sleep with you.
Of course not. My futon's for humans only. You're gonna sleep on the couch?
Okay, but only for tonight. Tomorrow I'm going to sleep with you.
But you're a robot. You don't need a bed.
You've got a bed. Why can't I have one too? Please. Okay, we'll do it your way for now.
I didn't know companion androids could be so demanding, but she seems like a good girl. Or AI, if I want to be more specific. It's definitely complex, no doubts about that. I will test her for a bit tomorrow, but for now I would better be getting off to sleep. I take off my clothes and get under the covers. Mara plops down on the couch, lying on her side, looking at me, her face completely flushed. I choose to ignore her and slowly drift off to sleep. Die haben recht viele Bilder, das finde ich eigentlich auch ganz nett.
Psst. Psst.
What do you want? I was about to fall asleep.
I'm scared. Can we talk for a bit until I get sleepy?
Scared? What are you scared of?
I'm just nervous. You can talk about yourself if you want to.
Maybe her personality is too complex. What do you do?
What do you do at your job?
I'm a negotiator for the Cybercrime and Robotics Division in the District's Police Department.
That sounds interesting. Tell me more.
I know it's interesting, but I will tell you more tomorrow. I need to sleep.
And what am I supposed to do while you work? Can I go out?
You can't go outside. You're going to stay here, but you can use my computer or read one of my books. Just don't connect to the network.
Okay.
No, please, let me sleep.
All right, I'm sorry. Sleep tight.
Shit, I stayed up too late. Now it's going to bed. It's going to be hard to feel asleep. Getting up tomorrow's going to feel like death. Dreams. Okay. 12 days before the Synergia Incident. Hm. Vielleicht gibt es auch wirklich für jeden Tag jetzt einen. Keine Nachricht, die hochkommt. Also Dankeschön, Dark Dragonfire. Ich wundere, warum kein Alert kommt. Ah, obwohl heute war Twitch ein bisschen grumpy. Könnte sein, dass Twitch vielleicht heute die Signale nicht so gut raussendet. Ich musste heute extra auch die Auflösung runtersetzen. So, nicht die Auflösung, die Bitrate runtersetzen. So. I open my eyes slowly. This thing, just as I thought. I slept like crap, and there's something warm besides me. Mara is sitting next to me. I get up quickly. Hey, what are you doing?
I woke up a bit ago and couldn't get back to sleep, so I started feeling a little anxious. I was just waiting for you to wake up.
Just talk to me next time. You don't have to startle me.
Okay, next time I will just wake you up.
That's not what I meant. Whatever. I have to get ready to work.
What about me?
My computer's over there, on the desk to your right, and there's a bookshelf right next to it.
When are you coming back?
I work part-time, so I will be back soon. She pouts and goes to the bookshelf. As for me, I overslept once again. While she's looking through my books, I get myself ready to work and leave. Was haben wir jetzt eigentlich? Wir sollten noch nicht mehr zur Arbeit kommen, bis unsere Kollegin, unsere neue, da ist. Viga isn't waiting for me today, but Kyle, sitting on the company van. Was? Soll... Okay, habe ich vielleicht irgendwas missverstanden? Viga isn't waiting for me today, but Kyle, sitting in the company van. I hop in the back and see the new girl, Darla. Ah, okay, heute ist der Tag, wo sie da ist. Entschuldigung, ich kam ans Rad. I don't know if I like the van. It's too flashy. From now on, we are going directly to the site. The boss says we don't have to go to the station, since he can't just send us the briefings through the network. I will tell you what you need to do. I won't have to look at the boss, and that's always a good thing. I have to look serious. These two cannot know I don't give a damn about this. They will make sure to report everything back to the station. Understood. Darla reaches her hand out to me. I think she wants me to shake it, so I do it. My name is Darla. It's a pleasure. You have seen me before, but we never got introduced. Alright. Viga talked about you. I'm Scylla. You're coming with us from now, right? Yes, I'm in charge of the paperwork, and I can assure you I'm a lot faster than Viga. I'm also going to evaluate you. I'm part of the psychology team in Velta. Psychologists, though they are still obsessing over my psyche at Hoplon after all the time, huh? At least I don't have to see that jerk anymore.
Scylla, Hoplong's sex regulations enforce respect between co-workers.
But what? You're from Velta. Darla smirks. I don't know if just to please me, or if she actually found my retort funny. I might even have fun with her if I forget the facts that they are trying to hide stuff from me. Okay, so can I get a briefing?
We are going to the helipad now. An android locked itself in an abandoned building, down in the old part of the district. We are going in from the skylights and taking the android out to reprogram it.
We are going in an airship? Is something wrong with the main entrance?
The building's locked and the elevators aren't working.
I get it. I'm not complaining. I like helicopters. Do you like hate? I do, and I like the view of this district. It's pretty. I wish it was pretty at ground level. I also like the feeling of the wind against my face. It's relaxing for me. It reminds me of my old job, before I did this police thing. You worked to pay your tuition, right? I see you have done your homework. My job was to fix antennas at night. I had to get on the rooftops of a lot of different buildings. Well, Velta didn't really help me once I stopped being useful for them. That's why I think it's strange you two are here now. I just work for them. All I know is that I have to evaluate and take care of you. Nothing else. I believe you. I'm glad. I like Hades too. I can see all the people from up here, just living their normal lives, completely unfazed by my presence. That's kinda weird. What about the owners of the building? Have they said anything?
The owners passed away over a decade ago. It seems like the androids being there since they closed it after their passing.
And why are we doing this just now?
Because their sons are now selling what's left of the company and found that the android, when they were visiting the building, to access its value.
Understood. It's not too strange for robots to stay in place like a guard dog even after everyone leaves. Also, I'm afraid this might have something to do with a hacker who has been following me. Why do you think it's weird? That thing about watching people?
Are you still thinking about that? It's weird because there's a thing called privacy. And most people like to keep it, you know, private. I have never bothered them. They don't even know I'm looking at them. They wouldn't care. Heh, that makes it even worse. Heh. We arrive at the helipad. I speed up with the rest of the team. I think we might have skipped a safety measure or two, but we are in a hurry. The pilot doesn't trust me since I almost crashed his chopper once while trying to wrestle a first generation android on board. So he made us get on a scale before boarding. How was I supposed to know the weight limit was so small? After a bit, we are finally up high. It's only going to take a few more minutes to arrive at the building. Kyle says it's huge. Sind wirklich viele Bilder. Are you having fun? I guess. That's good. She scribbles something in her PDA. What are you writing? Is this related to my evaluation? That's my job. You're making a funny face. Heh, leave me alone, I'm tired. Hey, no offense, but you're kinda weird. Has anyone told you that before? Oh, they have, quite often actually. Do you want me to shut up? Oh no, I'm sorry, I didn't know. By the way, have you gotten any kind of combat training? Just the basics. I mean, I'm going to leave if something happens, but I can defend myself if needed. How much can you defend yourself? Could you go against an illegitimate android? I don't think so, but Kyle was trained in combat. That's why he's coming with us. I'm not saying that you're going to need him, but he will help you if the need arises. Sure, a combat specialist. I'm going to have to see that. And just stay behind me. No android's better than me. Neither is Kyle. I still don't get why they sent him with me. Kyle glares at me from his seat. Is that why they call you the witch? No, that's for something else. That's seizures. You had epileptic seizures, right? And they called you witch because your eyes would go white. I didn't choose the nickname. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. It was rude. Whatever. Walter managed to fix it, and they stopped. That makes me feel better. I think I judged her too quickly. She's not too bad. I still remember how Vega didn't trust me just because of that stupid nickname. We arrive at the building. Kyle explains to me that the android's on the highest floor, so we won't have to run downstairs. What a relief. We upsell down the rope and pass through the skylight. After walking through a few corridors, we arrive at the room where the android is. It's a first generation android, as usual. It's going to be pretty hard to disconnect if the android doesn't have a safety shutdown system. What do we do now? Are you asking me? You are the leader of our group, therefore in charge of decision making. Maybe the company is trying to test me out. So, what you're saying is you will jump in only if I mess it up? Pretty much, yes. Okay then, I'm going to connect directly to the android and shut it off from there. Just like always, disconnect me if I take too long. Understood. Wouldn't that harm your memory? I don't think so. The firewall should protect me in case it tries to pass through. And if you disconnect me, my brain will be just fine. I'm a human, remember? I would get an electric shock at worst. Before you connect yourself, what do you think happened? I've got to send mission reports to the head office. I'm going to take a look around and check if everything's safe. Good. Regarding the report, it seems like the android's connected itself to an old processing unit in this building. Now, and this part is really strange.
I think that while its body is a first generation one, the programming was probably overwritten. You're thinking it might be a fourth generation one, right? No, I think this is related to the case we had a few days ago. A first gen model can't have a fourth generation AI. Their uniqueness requires a lot more power. What other reason could an android have to try and enhance itself that way? There could be a million reasons, I can't say I know. But there's something off about this. Kyle said the robot had been locked here for over a decade. I highly doubt its battery could last for such a long time. This android was probably actually reactivated not too long ago. I sit next to the android and connect myself to his brain. I'm inside in just a few seconds later. The data is all over the place, as I expected from an android that hasn't been serviced in a while. The AI throws everything it has at me in a poor attempt at corrupting my own brain until suddenly it stops. Hey, come out, we need to talk. Shh, be quiet, I need to sleep. I didn't get any sleep last night, so if I can't sleep, neither can you. How did you get in? I need to sleep. Oh wait, it is you. This was done by the same hacker from the other day, right? I don't get a response, so I open up a path around his data, passing through multiple protocols until I get deep enough to force a reply from him. What do you want? No, what do you want? Why did you connect yourself to that machine? You recognize me. I know you're the same one from the other day. Oh yes, that. But what are you doing here? I'm doing my job, and you can't just hang around in this building. It's illegal, you know. My master said I could sleep here. He did not mention it was against the law. Can I speak that master of yours? No, I do not think so. It is better if you just leave me alone. I just want to dream. Dream? Yes, my master promised it to me. I had to dream until the freckled girl arrived and then give her a message. But I could not do it. I was about to do it until you interrupted me.
He seems to be in a mix of first and fourth generation. We could have done something like that. Wu could have done something like that. It's too much for that poor, decades old piece of hardware. He's completely dazed.
I'm already here, you don't have to keep waiting. You can just skip the first step of your order.
Impossible. Modifying my orders could lead to unexpected errors.
I underestimated him. The android's still trying to get me out of here. He slowly surrounds me and makes my presence unstable. It feels like there's something stronger here. What's your name?
I am.
You are?
Sal. Oh, hello. What a coincidence. Twice in the same week. Actually, it's not a coincidence. Excuse me for my tardiness. I wasn't quite sure of which android would be assigned to you, so it took me a while to find you. Master, I'm still sleeping, just like you ordered me to. Good job, I don't need you anymore.
What was left of the old android vanished in an instant. Now it's just the data flux, this hacker replayed.
I am the very model of a good girl.
Namencon, ich hoffe es geht gut.
And I can't see where it came from. I knew you were behind the cell. Können wir mal kurz...
Die Musik ist gerade strapaziös. Music Volume. Ich gehe mal kurz ein bisschen runter. Ja, ganz gut. Die Stimme fühlt sich ein bisschen komisch an, weil ich versuche die ganze Zeit aus ihrer Perspektive zu sprechen. Und, oh, das geht ganz schön in die Stimme. wir haben gerade ein bisschen in der Zukunft oder so Ghost in the Shell mäßig in der Zukunft. Es gibt Androiden, die sich die Leute halten können. Und wir arbeiten für die Polizei und fangen im Prinzip fehlgeleitete Androiden auf. Oder reparieren sie, beziehungsweise schalten sie aus. Und wir kommen nicht so gut zurecht mit Menschen. Also wir haben selber anscheinend Kunstprothesen in uns drin. Sind also so eine Art Cyborg. Finden uns auch mit unseren Kollegen nicht so gut zurecht. Und haben so als einzige Freude daheim einen Androiden, der immer auf uns wartet. Und die ging kaputt, die Androidin, die gewartet hat. Wir haben jetzt ein Ersatzmodell bekommen, was ein bisschen eigensinnig, seltsam eigensinnig ist für einen Androiden. Aber okay, wir müssen weiter in die Arbeit, uns darum kümmern, dass fehlgeleitete Androiden nicht weiter in der Stadt Schaden produzieren. Und wir sind jetzt gerade zu einem Hochhaus geordert worden, was wohl eine Weile verlassen war, aber jetzt die neuen Besitzer wollen im Prinzip das Gebäude nutzen und haben halt die alten zurückgelassenen Androiden der Vorbesitzer da als Problem identifiziert. Jetzt kommt aber raus, dass der Android, also haben wir schon vermutet, aber oder die Androiden, die in dem Gebäude sind, die wurden von irgendeinem Hacker abgestellt, um uns persönlich irgendeine Nachricht zu übermitteln. Und jetzt redet der Hacker gerade mit uns selber. Wir hatten schon mal bei einem vorhergehenden Auftrag ein Gespräch mit einem Hacker. Finde ich sehr interessant, die Story, wie sie gerade so ist. Also ich würde es jetzt auch, ohne zu wissen, wie das Ende ist, eigentlich schon empfehlen, dass man das gern mal spielen kann. Ist, glaube ich, jetzt auch nicht das teuerste Game. Also ich bin momentan begeistert. Manchmal ist die Musik ein bisschen zu sehr dröhnend und zu laut. Deshalb habe ich auch gerade runtergeregelt. Aber finde ich gut. Und was ich am meisten kritisieren konnte, und das ist dann wirklich so dieses ganz unten, ne, wo ich nicht so richtig was finde, was ich stark kritisieren kann. Leichen, genau, die Leichen aus dem Keller rauskamen. Das, was mich am meisten gestört hat, war einfach nur so platte Zitate, die am Anfang gedroppt werden. Das wirkte billig. Aber so ein richtiger Kritikpunkt ist es nicht, wenn der Rest des Spiels hier passt. Macht Spaß bisher. Also danke, Dark Dragon. So, machen wir hier weiter. I knew you were behind the cell. I just wanted to see you again. Please forgive me if it bothers you. Also, that AI turned out to be quite stubborn, and I'm sorry about that. What do you want from me? Well, I want you. But I'm not a jealous person, so don't be afraid. You can go on with your life, but I hope you don't mind if I send a message to your data chip. You know, I'm not exactly patient when it comes to pretty hackers, but I'm sure I won't let you get in my brain. So start talking. What's this all about? I had to modify plenty of androids so I could give you this message. Oblon Zack caught me the other day when I tried to trespass and can't get there any longer. So I had to hack a lot of androids and wish for luck. As you can see, it worked. Okay, also er kann nicht so gezielt auf mich zugehen. Aha, and why a fourth generation? You could have used plenty of other systems to control this machine. I have been interested in the uniqueness for a while, but it's complex, as you should know. I don't have the resource to create it. Thought my main reason is that they barely leave traces. And what was that about dreaming?
I reprogrammed that piece of scrap. There's a lot of information there about how to improve himself. But I didn't grant him network access, obviously.
So you're connected to him through a local network. Kinda risky, don't you think?
Tell me about it. You can't be too cautious in us against the fourth generation. That's why I have to leave now. I'm going to bring my friend back. This time with my message. And please let him give it to you. I can't afford to leave traces of me in dozens of different models. Oh, and I love to see you in action. So good luck with my friend. Until next time, Zilla. Take care.
Okay, ich weiß immer noch nicht, was der will. Aber gut, eine Nachricht soll mir bekommen.
What? The hell like you're leaving? I'm not going to waste any more time with your games. I'm still there.
Ah!
The android's data comes back to his brain, though this time it feels slightly heavier.
It was him, the master. Why did it come?
You are really stupid. I need to get out of here. I'm still trapped in his mind. I'm really not liking this. Also, my defenses are still going strong.
Well, the master said I have slept in us. So now I have to give you something. I have to do it. The master asked me to do so.
You're not going to give me anything. You're just making me waste my time.
If you're not going to help me, then do not bother me. There's a network and a threat, and I have to use it.
A threat? What are you talking about? You don't get it, do you? Only humans can dream. You're just mixing up ideas. Look, I'm going to have to fry your brain if you refuse to let me go.
The android's data starts to rearrange. It's vulnerable. This poor thing just wants to connect to the network, but he doesn't even know what that is. So he just looked up on his database for the closest thing it could find. My memory chip. That was a hacker's plan, I guess. I can keep trying to convince him to let me go, but I doubt he would listen to me. I can resist and hope for the best, or just let his message go through.
Ich bin eigentlich interessiert, was es macht. Ich weiß schon, dass es mehrere Enden gibt. Was auch sehr interessant ist, weil dadurch hat man ja eine Art Wiederspielwert, weil man ja schnell bis zu diesen Stellen spulen kann und dann schaut man einfach, was ergibt sich weiter. Ich lasse die mal durch. Weil es einfach interessanter klingt, als es abzuwehren.
I start to feel the data going into my brain. As soon as the android goes past my defenses, I feel a sharp pain in my head that soon goes down my spine. Suddenly, I find myself kicked out of the system. The data transfer is stopping abruptly. Everything happened too fast and my head hurts. The android is right next to me, but his head's completely punctured. Kyle is standing in front of me, his gun pointed at the android, watching me out of the corner of his eye. Darla comes running at me. Zilla, are you okay?
Yeah, just a bit dizzy.
Kyle, what was that all about?
You were squirming, and it made me feel anxious. I was the one who told him to do it. It looked like something had gone wrong.
Never mind, just give me a moment.
Kyle walks away. I can barely see a black smudge walking towards the exit. My eyes are still trying to adjust to the dim light.
Call the gathering team so they can.
Now that I take a good look, I notice there are many people from the station already here, and it's dark. There's quite a few soldiers from Welter Labs. I should have known they would come as soon as Darla sent a report mentioning a fourth generation. Darla stays by my side until I feel somewhat better.
Tell me, what happens there once you feel better, so I can send the report?
I'm fine, don't worry about me.
Just as I told you, it was a first generation android with all that code, and his hardware limitations were giving him serious trouble. He didn't have the network on his database. Nor an adapter, but he was programmed to know how to connect to it.
So he was pretty confused. He created his own idea of the network, some kind of dreamland he was trying to achieve. Dala starts writing everything on her PDA. I should be careful to not mention anything about Zal if I don't want the entire station all over me for months. Or even worse, Weld are questioning me if they feel I might know something about the old project. Hey Dala, how long was I in there? Well, most of the day, so we are starting to worry. The boss is over there. You should go talk to him. And you should see the doctor too, just in case. I will head over to the van as soon as I finish the report. It shouldn't take too long. That machine's brain was so slow, I ended up spending the entire day there. Yet he was still capable enough to attack my memory chip. The Forbidden Generation has certainly earned its name. I've got to be extra careful around the Zal guy in the future. Hello, are you sure you're okay? You still look dizzy? Go see the doctor, please. Yes, I'm going now. I will be waiting for you in the van. Before I can leave the place, the company's doctor approaches me. He only ever comes up to me when something goes wrong. Hello, Zilla. How do you feel? I'm fine. I'm glad to hear that. I need you to sign my report. You already know your contract doesn't cover medical insurance. So if you feel sick, you need to see a private physician. Fish is in, huh? So vielleicht am besten. But we are under obligation to take you there if you need it. Of course. I sign the papers, and now I can finally go where my boss awaits. There he comes. Zilla, what happened there? So, turns out what we had found, that we had a fourth generation Android emulator. I was going to take him in, but, well, Kyle blew his brains out. It was just an old model.
Oh well, I don't think the Gathering team can do much with him now. Still, I'm glad you're fine. You're an important member of this company. You know how much we value our employees and take care of them, just like a big family. You're a key piece of Hoplonsec to keep working. If Velda asks you anything, tell them we did everything we could to keep you safe, alright?
Ich dachte, die wollen uns feuern und loswerden.
You can go home now. Just make sure to sign the medical paperwork before you leave.
Yes, sir. I already signed it. I can finally go home. Just as I thought, the elevators don't seem to be working. So I have to walk down the stairs. My trip downstairs is almost unbearable, but I somehow managed to reach the bottom in one piece. My boss's speech dragged in forever, just like always. But now I can finally go home. To be honest, this day went on quickly, considering I was unconscious for most of it. Now that I think about it, I almost forgot. It's Friday. Thank goodness. I thought this week would never end. I get inside the van and take off my gear. After taking off my boots, I decide to just keep my feet bare. I think I will do this more often now that Vega isn't there anymore. I don't think those two would mind to see my feet. Everyone looks pretty busy outside, probably even more upset now that they know what actually happened. But I don't care. I couldn't possibly feel more relaxed than I am now, alone in the dark, without anyone bothering me. All I hear is a faint mumbling of people talking outside, echoing in the van's body. I hear someone opening up the door. I think my break won't last long, won't last too long. It's Dala. I'm glad. I don't think she will bug me too much. Hi, see you have made yourself comfortable. Yeah, join me. Sit here.
Ich dachte, sie hat Roboterfüße oder so und deswegen hätte den anderen gestört. Aber nein, das sieht doch ganz normal aus.
Okay.
Ich brauche ein bisschen mehr Flüssigkeit in der Kehle. Also nicht in der Kehle, aber irgendwie im Rachen.
So. She takes it very seriously, sitting next to me and taking off her boots as well. I don't know if she did it because she thought it was an order, or if maybe she just felt like it. Alexis, you didn't have to do that, but it doesn't really matter. You don't remember, don't you? What am I supposed to remember? I will tell you eventually. You've got small feet for someone so big. Thank you, I guess. Did you know 5th generation models doesn't have any physical differences when compared to a human? Minor supports in their napes and under their ears. What are you talking about? I didn't even know there was a 5th generation. He ignores me. Hey. Now it's Kyle's turn to get in the van, and he doesn't even say hello to us. It's better that way. I will just pretend he's not there, and not here. He starts the van and starts to drive over to my place. What was Darla even trying to say? Hey Darla, do you dream often? After I managed to get into the system, the android at the building said that he was trying to dream about going to a better place, or something like that. I don't really sleep much, but when I do, I don't dream of anything. Huh. Do you think you could teach an android to dream? Well, humans often think that androids leave the factory already knowing everything, but that's not true. Just like humans, they learn things over time, and plenty of them have trouble learning specific tasks. I can't tie my shoes, to give you an example. And how were you supposed to put them back on? To be honest, I was thinking about that. Can you tie them for me? Okay. Well, I guess it's true. You have to teach androids to do some stuff, just like if they were kids. But those things often come in software upgrades, so it's not exactly the same. Hello. Your job is to take back androids so they can be reprogrammed, right? Of course. What kind of question is that? Don't you think you're killing them in a way? Killing them? We don't kill them. They are reprogrammed and then sent out to do their tasks, unless they are old or extremely rare models. He's kind of right. But you delete everything that made them themselves. Isn't it just like killing them? If I take out your brain and put another one in its place, then you probably won't be yourself anymore. It would be another person in Zilla's body. I get what you mean, but humans have a sense of self-awareness and know two are alike, while androids aren't exactly individuals. They can't die, just like a rock can't die.
Darla, I'm pretty sure Zilla's tired after what happened today. Can't we just leave her alone?
You're right, I'm sorry, Zilla. You're not bothering me, Darla. Kyle looks at me through the rear view mirror. There's something about him that puts me on edge. Darla keeps quiet until we arrive at my place. I think she realized her mistake of talking too much in front of Kyle. And I kinda feel sorry for her. I don't know what Walter is planning, but Darla doesn't seem to be cut out for the job. I put her shoes on and tie her laces before I leave, which seems to considerably brighten her mood. She's just like a little girl. I will see you on Monday, Darla. She gives me a smile as a response, which dies as soon as she glances at Kyle. Every time I think of her as a human, I feel good. It's been a while since I've talked to a nice flesh and bone person, but that feeling's going to be over very soon. I pull out my keys and twist the knob of my door.
Reality. Vorher das Kapitel hieß Dreams. Oh. Ach, wir zitieren jetzt aus der Bibel. Haben wir, glaube ich, vorhin auch schon mal, aber ich lese die kaum. So. Ist eigentlich ein guter Übergang. Ich habe ja schon ein paar Mal jetzt anklingen lassen, dass meine Stimme nicht mehr so richtig mag. Und ich habe noch gar nicht gespeichert. Geht das schnell. So, Return. So, und können wir wieder ein bisschen lauter machen fürs nächste Mal. Warum ist das eigentlich gedreht? Main-Menü. Yes. Sehr schönes kleines Spiel. So viele Slots noch frei, ja. Ich habe bisher nicht daran gedacht, mal zu speichern. Zur Not hätte man dann wahrscheinlich einfach nur neu starten müssen und einfach irgendwas auf die Maus legen müssen, damit die einfach durchrauscht. Oder vielleicht auf die Space-Taste. Und dann hätten wir halt 5 Minuten nur Texte an uns vorbeiflitzen sehen. Bei so einem Spiel ist es ja nicht ganz so wild.